This is Mrs. Oberg from room 12. Today we're going to be practicing some addition for our math. Now you need to remind yourself what addition means. Have to think back to all those posters in your classroom that your teachers have posted. We can remember that addition means plus. So all of our math problems today are going to be plus. They're going to be adding. Our numbers are going to keep getting bigger and bigger the more we add. We're going to start with some problems together, and then we're going to have some time to work on problems by yourself. Before we work on our problems together, you're going to need a few things. So you're going to need something to write with and something to write on. So you might need a piece of paper, maybe a pen, a pencil, a marker, a crayon, anything you have at home that you can write with. So now's a good time to pause your video so you can go gather your supplies. Now that you have your supplies, we can get started. So today, when we're practicing together, I will just be writing the problems, giving you some time to think about them, and then it's going to be your job to answer the problems. So first, we're going to start out pretty simple. It may have been a little bit of time since you've done some math. So our first math problem today is going to be 5 plus 8. And remember, there are many ways to solve these problems. You can use strategies like counting on your fingers, counting on. You can use a number line that you draw on your piece of paper at home. You can use counters. And you might be thinking, I don't have counters at home like I have at school. But you can use things like your toys. If you have anything at home like beans or pasta, you can use those as counters. Just make sure that you ask your family before you use any food for counters. Excellent. Now that you've had a little bit of time to solve your math problem, we're going to work together to solve it. For this problem, I use the counting on method. So I picked the biggest number and saved that in my head. And then I'm going to use counting on 5 more. So I'm going to start on 8 and count 5 more. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So you should have gotten the answer for 8. 5 plus 8 equals 13. We're going to try another one next. And I want you to try and use a different strategy that you didn't use to find 5 plus 8. Next, we're going to try 6 plus 4. If you need more time to solve these problems, you can always pause the video to give yourself some more time to solve the problem. For 6 plus 4, I'm going to use the strategy of counting on my fingers. So first I'm going to count 6, and then I'm going to count 4 more. So I have 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 6 plus 4 we can see equals 10. We're going to practice 2 more together, and then it's going to be your job to practice on your own. Why don't we try one that's a little bit more challenging? We're going to try 12 plus 3. Gets a little bit more challenging because it is a double digit number. So we have a number in the tens place and in the ones place. To solve 12 plus 3, I'm going to draw a number line. So I'm just going to draw a number line here. And label my number line. I drew my number line to start at 1 and end at 20. I know it's small, so let's see if we can get a closer up version of our number line. Because we're solving the problem 12 plus 3, we know we need to start at 12 and make 3 hops. 1,
two, three. And we can see we land on number 15. So that's going to tell us that 12 plus 3 equals 15.
Now that we've worked on some problems together, it's your turn to work on some problems by yourself. This is where, if you found those problems too easy for you, this is where you can make it more challenging. So for this part of your assignment, you're going to use your own numbers to make addition problems. I know in my class in room 12, a lot of times we'll use dice to get numbers. So if you have dice at home, that might be a good way to find your addition problems. If you don't have dice at home, you can ask a bigger brother or sister, or even a little brother or sister. You can ask your family to give you some numbers, or you can just think of some on your own. So this is how that part will work. You're gonna have to think of 10 different addition facts. And this is where you're gonna film your video to show your teacher your math work. So if you have dice at home and you're practicing with your dice, you might roll your dice. Ooh, and the first number I got is 2. So I'm gonna say 2 plus, I'm gonna roll it again, I got 6. Then it's gonna be my job to solve the problem. 2 plus 6 equals 8. So that's gonna be number 1. Number 2, you're gonna have to think of new numbers. Maybe you don't have a dice at home, and so you ask your brother to give you a number. And your brother tells you 9 and 5. So then it's your job to find what's 9 plus 5. And we know that 9 plus 5 equals 14. And you're gonna do this all the way until you get to number 10. When you make your video for your teacher, you will show your teacher the work you did on your paper. So it's important that you're writing it on your paper so that you can show your teacher all the math work you did. If you're looking for something a little bit more challenging, this is how you can make it more challenging. You, instead of having one digit numbers with only a number in the ones place, you can make all your numbers have numbers in the tens place and the ones place. So you might want to do numbers like 14 plus 12, or if you're looking for something even more challenging, you could do something like 23 plus 13. Because you have some extra time at home, this might be a fun time to make this math game a little bit more challenging. Bye!